One of the main strategic objectives of the Faculty of Economics is to become world known for the quality of its academic programs and achievements in education and research. The fact that we have now joined about 600 AACSB accredited business schools around the world, among them only 11 in Europe, with active Beta Gamma Sigma chapters, confirms that we are on the right path. And why is membership in the Beta Gamma Sigma chapter so important to our school? This is the question I pose to our dean, Professor Dušan Mramor.
Spoštovani, smo še vedno slovenska univerza, slovenska fakulteta, ampak zelo, zelo mednarodna. Tako da mi dovolite, čeprav je nekaj študentov tudi, ki so tujci, da vas nagovorim v slovenskem jeziku, tako so se tudi dogovorila s profesor Michael Bryantom. Beta, gamma, sigma. Čast, modrost, iskrenost in prizadevnost so vrednote častnega svetovnega združenja najboljših diplomantov, najkakovostnejših poslovnih šol na svetu, tistih, ki imajo ACSB akreditacijo. To so vrednote, ki jih Ekonomska fakulteta Univerze v Ljubljani deli s častnim združenjem Beta Gamma Sigma, zato tudi odločitev, da svojim najboljšim diplomantom omogočimo postati člani tega združenja. Seveda, zato je bilo potrebno najprej pridobiti AACSB akreditacijo, kar nam je vzelo približno 10 let. Članstvo je častno, možno samo na posebno povabilo, kot smo že slišali. Članstvo je signal vsem, med njimi tudi zaposlovalcem, da imajo opravka z izjemnim človekom. Članstvo je seveda tudi prednost. Trenutno recimo je posebna skupina, 21 tisoč članov ima na LinkedInu, tisoč jih čaka v vrsti na potrditev, da so člani Beta Gamma Sigma, ki bojo lahko potem postali del te skupine. Skupine so tudi na Facebooku, na Twitterju in te skupine so izjemna mreža poznanstev, seveda na katerih lahko temeljite tako svoj razvoj, kot tudi informacije, ki jih potrebujete. Obstaja poseben karierni spletni center na tem združenju Beta Gamma Sigma, kjer se zbirajo zaposlitvene ponudbe. Trenutno je 2300 ponudb na tem kariernem spletnem centru. Res, da večina v ZDA, 35 samo zunaj ZDA, vendar tukaj zagotovo možnosti so. So možnosti za ekspertne karierne nasvete in cela vrsta drugih možnosti, za katere verjamem, da ste že slišali. Izjemno sem vesel, da je Ekonomska fakulteta Univerze v Ljubljani prva v zelo široki regiji in 12. v Evropi, ki za takšnimi šolami, kot so recimo City University London, Maastricht University, St. Gallen University, ki je ustanovila ta chapter, ta klub, in da ste vi predstavniki prvih dveh generacij, ki boste danes postali člani kluba Beta Gamma Sigma Ekonomske fakultete Univerze v Ljubljani. S modrostjo, iskrenostjo in prizadevnostjo častno nosite to izjemno priznanje in mu vsak dan povečujte ugled v svoji sredini. To je zelo pomembno. Tako kot ni bilo poznano, kaj pravzaprav pomeni akreditacija EQUIS, kaj pomeni akreditacija AACSB, potrebovali smo vrsto let, da so podjetja, zaposlovalci, država spoznali vrednost teh akreditacij. Tako bo trajalo tudi nekaj časa, da se bodo začeli zavedati, kaj pomeni Beta Gamma Sigma. Pomagajte nam, da bodo ljudje zvedeli, kaj to je. Se pravi, najboljši diplomanti najboljših šol. Iskrene čestitke vsem vam. Brez dvoma ste si jih zaslužili. Čestitam.
Thank you. And now we continue in English. Faculty of Economics is proud to enjoy great support of its advisory board that is comprised of 27 executives from the best Slovenian companies. Together, we share one common goal: to prepare our graduates to step on their career paths armed with skills that add value in this ever-changing business environment. In line with that is Beta Gamma Sigma, as this is recognized throughout the business world as the leading honor society for business and management education. Additionally, corporate recruiters actively seek individuals who have been elected to membership in Beta Gamma Sigma. And now it is time to invite to the stage one of the members of the Faculty of Economics Advisory Board, Mr. Janez Krabat. He's not only a founder and director of a very successful Slovenia-based international company, Riko Group, and a member of many honorable and professional societies, but also our alumni and one of the fellow alumni corporate recruiters. And now, Mr. Janez Krabat, the floor is yours.
Spoštovani profesor gospod Mramor, dekan ekonomske fakultete, profesori, kolegi, naprošen sem bil, da preberem svoj govor v angleščini, zato sem poslužil tega jezika. Since I have left the Faculty of Economy, I have returned to this stand several times. My returns have always been pleasant, most of all because of the vitality and joy with which this institution goes beyond boundaries and opens doors, initiatives like today's joining of the Beta Gamma Society. Society is an organization with tradition spanning over 100 years. The noble mission is to concept the best students in the spirit of the highest values. I come from another era, which did not know of such organization. Limitations, principles, and standards were set by collective values, and this controlled the moral balance in an environment without any pronounced individualism. I cannot say that this was always bad. But regardless of the type of system you are coming from, when you make a step over academic wisdom into life, you are alone with your decisions and choices. If I look at my business environment, many glittering names of individuals as well as businesses have found themselves in financial ruin or even worse. And it cannot be said that these were the gamblers. At one time, people may have only been carried away by possibilities that seemed unlimited, or perhaps they were too taken by the rising graphs of success and forgot that they are vulnerable. And in many cases, also because they simply could not cope with the responsibility of management. My experience and belief tell me that entrepreneurial stories cannot be built separately from the broadest regard for the world with its culture, with the pulse of the moment, and especially with the positive values. The capital that you accumulate is not only measured by the value of your shares, but rather by the growth of your environment. This is the first rule, which I would like to place at the heart of every person at the start of their career path. Breathe with your surroundings. Riko is a successful company, but also a company that lives with its environment, regenerating the power that has been imposed here by tradition. Since wood processing is 100 years old tradition of Rimnica Valley, we have decided to carry on with it. I call this the principle of roots and wings. People have roots which are anchored in their environment. We use them to draw knowledge and support and strength when we are in doubt. And we have wings to give flight to our imagination and boldness. They can take you far. For instance, Rico is now working with Philip Stark, the world-renowned designer who has chosen us for his partner in his latest project, creating superior quality for the masses. But of course, coming so far, a good head for business and well-considered decision-making was required too. If everyone at Rico did not have high ambitions, which went hand in hand with the company's vision and cutting-edge production, then our big step forward would not have taken place. In order for us to have made it so far, because every worker had to be in it. And this leads us to the third realization, which I would like to use to knock on your conscience. Never forget that you are jointly responsible for every co-worker. It used to be said that money was paid for mastery. And now it is also true to say that membership and participation can be paid for by sense of purpose. Just think how many people are willing to work for free in non-governmental and humanitarian organizations. Today's talent requires money and meaning, worth and values. I see my role in creation of fertile ground on which every individual can cultivate their own individual gifts. Everyone is important, and I must encourage everyone to do what they are really good at so that they become willing participants in the creation of Rico stories. I tried not to give the orders. I prepare to follow the wise realization that the leader indicates the target and then leaves those chosen one to hit it in any way that he thinks may be best. I create the ideal employee myself. I like to socialize with my colleagues when I get the time, and I admit it, I do enjoy it a lot. Head, heart, and conscience. Three old-fashioned words that always work if they are led by healthy ambition. Ambition is our inner light which takes us forward. If ever, these values are important today. When adversity strikes, when our rules and security mechanisms are breaking down, when ordered society begins to grow to jungle proportions, then people can often turn into the beasts. You may have recently read the brilliant column by Boris Dežulović, who drew comparisons between the sinking Titanic and the Costa Concordia disaster. The outcome was devastating for our time. 100 years ago, the weak were given